Peace and love. Hey, soul family. Hey, soul tribe. How y'all doing? It's your girl, TriceyCheaa, coming to you with Thriving Thursday. I hope everybody's doing well. Make sure you like, subscribe, share. If you're feeling generous and want to contribute to the channel, you can leave a gratitude donation. And that information is down below in the description. Life is your birthright, they hit that in a fine print. Take a pen and rewrite it.
Step out your wisdom, step in your wisdom to know that you're excellent.
Right.
Spirit is teaching, no, I'm not just preaching.
I'm taking my own advice.
Let mama let you know. Mama's too strong, and I can't get no days off.
Alright, you guys, that's Beyonce, Bigger, and I want to go ahead and thank God, Source, and the Universe for using me as a vessel, using me as a channel to bring forth this message to you all. I ask that it be none of me and more of you, Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, that you give me an accurate message for my beautiful, lovely collective. Alright, so I went ahead and got some angel prayers for us. See which one of our archangels are supporting us around this time. What we have to be thankful for, what's going on behind the scenes. So we have, thank you angels for helping me step back from what's not serving me, people, places, things that are not serving me. Thank you, loved ones in heaven, for drawing close to me at this time. I know you are here. I feel your presence. I'm seeing the signs. I'm getting the familiar sensations, you know, smells, feelings. Thank you, angels, for inspiring me to be more like you. Loving, sincere, honest, loyal earth angels. Light beings, seekers of the truth, thank you for helping me be more like you. 404, thank you angels for opening up doors to change. I am ready for this change, for this game. Ain't no more fear, my destiny is near. Calling me home, here I come, I'm coming for this new beginning. Thank you, Gabrielle, for helping me to speak with integrity, speak my truth, okay? No more playing small for anybody. It's time to wake up everybody who was sleeping on me. Been sleeping on it too long. It's time to wake up. Time to turn on the light. Thank you, angels, for guiding me through my inner voice. It's time to do what you have been being guided to do. What they have been telling you God, source, universe, your ancestors, the inner voice, that knowing feeling, it's time to get to work. You better move that mountain, move that mountain, move that mountain, move. Thank you, angels, for blessing me with infinite abundance. Yes, infinite abundance. I got more than enough. I got more. I got more than enough. I got more. I am more than enough. I am more. Period. Thank you, Ariel, for helping me stand my ground with peace. Because I understand that everything is not a fight. You got to pick and choose your battles. Everything does not need to be energy wasted on things that, you know, really don't matter. It's really not that big of a deal. So thank you for helping me stand my ground with peace. Thank you for giving me discernment. Thank you for allowing me to know how to transmute any energy that is not in alignment with my highest self, okay? Thank you, angels, for motivating me to move my body and energy. Y'all better get outside because it feels so good here in Nebraska. It feels so freaking good, and I'm loving it. I hope it stays like this because I'm sick of winter, okay? Come early spring. I'm here for you. Thank you, Jafael, for helping me discover my inner and outer beauty. Yeah. Because my inner beauty is so magnetic. My outer beauty, I mean, it's just there. I'm radiating from the inside out. Like, it's all in conjunction, okay? Thank you, angels, for allowing me to see that every day is a learning day. Every day is a learning day. Every day. It's a learning day for you. It's a learning day. Thank you, Zakiya, for supporting me transform from my past challenges. Yes, you gotta move them mountains. Move them mountains. Move them mountains. Move. You gotta go through things to grow through things. To learn that every lesson is a blessing, okay? Trials and tribulations is here for you to gain that knowledge and that insight and that wisdom. It's not here to hurt you. It's working for you, for your good. I'm ready to take a leap, angels. Thank you for doing it with me. Indeed. Thank you for doing it with me. I know I ain't got to go through this transformation by myself. I know I don't have to fear because you are here. You are near. You are protecting me. Archangel Michael, thank you for protecting me, surrounding me with your protective light, that blue aura, that energy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Animal Kingdom, for blessing my path with love. Yes, connecting with animals is so nurturing. Even if it's spiritually, what animals are coming to you? What animals are you hearing? What animals are repeatedly popping up on your screen via social media? What animals are you hearing on the radio? Pay attention. Thank you, angels, for supporting me as I follow my joy, because I know I am a part of something way bigger than me. I am following the path that you are leading me to. Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, thank you. Thank you, angels, for guiding me to love through meditation. Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and read from the Simple Abundance, a day book of comfort and joy, okay? Simple Abundance, a day book of comfort and joy. Okay. So we have priming the pump for inspiration. The well providence is deep. The well of providence is deep. My love runs deeper than the ocean. Okay. It's the buckets we bring to it that are small. Yes, y'all. Yes, y'all. Yes, y'all. That's why I be asking for an overflow of abundance. An overflow because, you know, what we have in mind, or like the prayers we're asking for, you know, can fit, let's say, you know, a bowl. But the blessings that God has in store for you, it's not going to fit inside that bowl. So we want to ask for overflow. I have more than enough. I got more. I have more than enough. I got more. Okay. Whenever I prepare to write, I have a carefully crafted ritual of comfort that eases me into creating. I work from my bed with a fresh pot of tea on my bedside table and a beautiful tape of piano playing softly in the background. Next to me is a new spiral notebook and cup full of my favorite pens, along with a pile of dog-eared books. You see, I am not alone, but in the company of my circle of saints. Okay, you're not alone. You got your spirit team, your ancestors, the animal kingdom, Mother Gaia. You got Father Sky, Mother Earth. You got them. Your support system. Of whom, each of whom has an authentic voice and a special message for me. I savor the work of their hands, hearts, and minds once again to get my own creative juices flowing. Yes, call them in, call them in, calling your peoples. Calling your peoples. My writing ritual is what I refer to as priming the pump for inspiration. When you have to pump water from a well the old-fashioned way by hand, you need to pour a pitcher of water down the pump to get it going. I prime my personal pump in a very particular way because the repetitiveness of the process activates the right side of my brain where creativity dwells. I use the same blue willow mug for the tea, listen to the same music, write with the same type of pens and notebooks, reread the same books. The instantly recognizable ritual informs my brain that I'm now working. That's why it's good to have a routine, to get up early in the morning, you know, before dawn, and to have that routine, get your juices flowing. That's the best time to connect to spirit. Before I realize it, I'm jotting down notes as if I'm taking dictation from spirit. Okay. When I've got a rough draft written in longhand, I head to my office to work on the computer. Then the real writing began. Once again, I have co-opted inspiration into helping me through the power of ritual, your meditation, your exercise, you listening to music, whatever you're doing. When you wake up in the morning, set a routine. When you go to bed, set that routine, okay? You need to create a reassuring ritual for yourself to assess your inner reserver. That place deep within you, inhabited by imagination. Why not create an inviting one for when you work with your illustrated discovery journal? If you find that you can't work on it every day, pick one night a week that you can devote to searching for the visual images that reveal your authentic preferences. You have to visualize it. You see it, you speak it, you write it, you take action, you make it happen. Make the process as appealing as possible. Perhaps after putting the children to bed, you can take a long, leisurely soak in the bathtub. Yes, your spiritual bath. Get you some, maybe a little bit of lavender, essential oil. Get you some roses, you know, some fruit. You know, get you some, just purify, cleanse that energy, okay? Then after you are comfortable and relaxed, bring the basket containing your magazine, scissors, and journal over to your bed. Prepare a special hot drink to enjoy at this time. Light a pretty candle on your dresser and invoke inspiration. This week, think of creating a reassuring ritual that primes your personal pump. Carry a large bucket to the well of providence with a ceremony of comfort. Exactly, y'all. Take action. Make a routine so you can write it out in your planner so you can be consistent, okay? So you can continue to grow. So you continue to learn. So you continue to connect to source and get the messages that are coming to you, the directions that are coming to you for your journey, okay? And think big. Think big. Now is not the time to play small or think small. What you want out of life, you can have. You have not because you ask not. It's time for you to start asking for that overflow, overflow, overflow. Ain't no pouring into empty cups. Ain't no only pouring, pouring, pouring and not receiving. No. None of that. You have to have an equal give and take. Make sure you're not being taken advantage of. Make sure you're not being used. Make sure you're connecting with trustworthy family and friends, okay? Because it's time for your overflow. Thank you, Spirit. All right, so we're going to, this is the third eye Tibetan singing bowl that I'm playing today in the A note. So hopefully this gives you some vision. You know, using your third eye, okay? You can really see what it is that Spirit is trying to have you see. Okay. So, we have, God would never give you anything you can't handle, so don't stress, don't stress. Yes, this new beginning, baby, is here for you. You have all the tools that you need to go ahead and take this leap into this new beginning, okay? You are standing in your truth. You are standing in your power. You are operating in love and light energy. You know what you need to do. You have to do your job. You have to come here and do what you were created to do. God gave you gifts and talents to be used, not to be hidden. It's time to show the world who you are. It's time to use your gifts. It's time to use your talents. We are in the new age awakening. There is a big ass shift happening. It's time for you to make sure you're walking in your truth and your alignment so that you can complete what you were created to do in this avatar, in this realm, in this existence, okay? And while you do that, you're going to be living your joy. Because what it is, it's going to be things that you love, things that you're good at, things that you're naturally talented and gifted at doing. Maybe you do have to get some education, go to school or whatever to do it, whatever, that's fine. But these are your God-given birthright gifts that have been sent to you. So it's time for you to live your joy so you can operate in your truth and do what you were created to do. Honor your beauty and honor your emotions inside and out. Seeds of faith are always within us. Sometimes it takes a crisis to nourish and encourage their growth. Exactly the things, trials, tribulations, heartache, pain, long nights, situations that, you know, we wouldn't wish on our worst enemy that you had to go through. It was all necessary things, not done to you, but done for you. You have to see the light at the end of the tunnel. You have to understand when you're going through situations where it's heavy, you got to be like, okay, this is teaching me something. What is this teaching me? What is this showing me? What is it that I need to be doing? Okay, what is it that needs to be taken in? What is it that I need not to do from here on out? Because I'm learning my lessons and I'm not going to repeat the same cycles over and over and over again because I done had enough. And enough is enough. I done went through it. I done grew through it. I don't have to go back and I will not go back. Okay, that's why we're taking this leap of faith and we got this new beginning coming. Faith is not belief without proof, but trust without reservation. Yes, you have to. You got your proof when you started up, because God gives you those thoughts and those visions to come to fruition. Okay. You just have to know that even if you're not seeing it happen right here, right now, it is going to happen. A delay does not mean it is denied, okay? When you focus on being a blessing, God makes sure that you are always blessed in abundance, infinite abundance, okay? You are walking in your truth. You're walking in your power. You're showing love wherever you go, okay? You're not hating on nobody. You're sending good energy. You're meditating and connecting to God's source, universe, okay? Speaking in your truth, all right? No matter what that looks like to anybody else, but being nice about it, you know, being respectful, but speaking in your truth, honoring your feelings, okay? There's nothing wrong with that. You're going to be blessed. Blessings on top of blessings. Every time I turn around, blessings, blessings, hey! Every time I turn around, blessings on blessings on blessings on blessings on But for real though, blessings. Pray as though everything depend on God. Work as though everything depend on you. Exactly. Pray about it and leave it in God's hands. But then take action, because now it's your part. You already prayed. You're going to get what you pray for. You ask for it, and it's in alignment with God, so it's the universe God in store for you. It's for your higher good. You're going to get what you ask for. And if it's not what you ask for, you're going to get something better than what you could imagine, because that's just the way spirit works. So don't fear. Don't worry. Just put in that action behind it, because it's going to take some work on your behalf as well. You can ask for it, but now you got to put in the work, the action, and it's going to come, okay? Patience is a virtue. It takes vision and courage to create. It takes faith and courage to prove. Vision and courage to create. The visions God has in your mind, the visions that you don't tell nobody because you're like, oh, this will never happen to me. Let me tell you something. Yes, it can happen to you. It just takes courage. It takes a plan. You don't want to just target that finished product. Make a plan. It's going to be so much simpler because you got the steps. You got the steps to get you to where you're trying to go, and it's going to come, okay? Then you got to have that faith and courage. You got to have the faith and courage to take that action. You can think it up. You can visualize it. But now you got to put it into action. Okay. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you, Spirit. Keep the faith. Don't lose your perseverance. And always trust your gut instincts. That inner voice. Trust it. Trust it. Because you got your loved ones in heaven telling you what you need to do. Your ancestors guiding you to the destination they're trying to get you to. You already know you're going through this transformation. It's a transformation. And it's, you're protected. You're protected. You got your peoples with you. The animal kingdom with you. Your spirit guides with you. You're seeing the synchronicities, okay? You're studying. You're learning new things every day about you. Your growth, the spiritual aspects of things, life in general, okay? We have one life and it soon will be past. What we do for God is all that will last. Yes, that's why you gotta step back from the things that are not serving you, were not serving you, because you need to be in alignment with what God has planned for you. Because we living in this life for a purpose. We were brought to this earth for a purpose, okay? And you can either choose to do your own thing, or you can choose to do what God has planned for you. Lean not on your own understanding, but trust in the Lord with all your heart. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path straight. Okay? God is the only person, only being, who you need to fear, and who can judge you, whose opinion matters. Don't nobody else's opinion matter, okay? But God. So forget what everybody else gotta say. Live your life, live your truth, your authentic self, what's best for you, all right? And you're gonna be blessed because God has the final say so, and God sees your heart. So operate out of your heart space, operate in love. Every tomorrow has two handles. We can take hold of it with the handle of anxiety or the handle of faith. Thank you, angels, for helping me move my body and my energy. Help me to remove any negative fear, doubt, lack, energy. Okay? We're not living in anxiety no more. That was in the past. We're not living in scarce, in fear, in lack, in depression. No. We rebuke that in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We are living in faith because we know having faith as small as a mustard seed can move a mountain. Okay? Having faith as small as a mustard seed is all you need, and you're going to receive the blessings. Blessings, blessings, so much infinite abundance and opportunities and blessings like the sand on the seashore. Okay, y'all? Like, do y'all know how much sand is on the seashore? Like, that's a lot of blessings, okay? So, like, y'all, you're part of something way bigger. Believe it. Let love be the water. Pour. Pour, overflow. Yes, you are a chosen child of God. You are His creation. You're gonna rise. You're part of something way bigger. Share that shit. That's why you have these things, okay? Final angel prayers. Thank you, angels, for helping me to focus on my priorities. Now is the time to focus on your priorities. Now is the time to take action. Thank you, Shamuel, for removing the barriers around my heart. Yes, I'm operating in my love energy. That is it. That is all. I don't care what the next person does to me. Because I don't have to answer for them. I answer for my actions and how I treat people. Thank you, angels, for inspiring me through music. Thank you for inspiring me through music. Yes, listen to the lyrics, y'all. You're part of something way bigger. Bigger than you. Bigger than me. Bigger than what you could have ever imagined it to be, okay? Yes, you're part of something way bigger. Thank you, angels, for helping me to reconnect through nature and fresh air. Get outside, y'all. Get outside. Get some of that sun. Thank you, Uriel, for helping me share my light with the world. Yes, you better. You better. Hey, for real. Thank you, Azrael, for leading me safely through this change. Yes. I am healthy. I am wealthy. I am rich. I am that. I am going to go get that bag, and I am not going to say, I am protected, well-respected. I do what I'm going to do, and I want to be because I am, hey, like, yes, just be you. Just be you. Be you. Stay true to you, all right? That is all I have for you all today. I love you, I love you, I love you. Tomorrow is, Monday is Meditating Monday. I will be back for that. So I will see you guys then. Thank you all. Namaste.